And we're back with Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We're in Andra's Gift, one of the districts of Defiance Bay. It's turning out to be a place where many different things can be found. What is that? What is that? I didn't notice that before. There's like a hole and there's like... I gotta go check that out. So yeah, if you go here, you can have sex. If you go here, you can have combat, so... It's pretty much a mixed bag. We haven't even checked out all these houses and the trading company and the people's individual houses and stuff. So we haven't even gone inside anywhere other than the Salty Mast, of course. I originally went in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I heard once day came we could walk around. The tide would recede, which I guess maybe... That's why we can walk around down here? I don't know if it's always like that. There's a fisherman told
us
that. Who knows if you can trust fishermen, I don't know. Amadon McNeely. Okay, this guy wasn't out before. Oh, we haven't been here before. You see a man probing at a lock, hunting for the click, click, click of success. It takes him more than a moment, but there it is. Click. He turns the needle further. Click. A smidge more. Click. His smile is all smug self-assurance as he pushes into the well-fortified building. He shivers as he steps over the threshold, pupils contracting briefly as the door swings shut of its own accord behind him. Click, click, click. Locked. He moves through the silent building, no subtlety to his search. He pockets nothing, despite the slack-jawed ache in his face, as he passes over jewelry and potions alike. Nobody stops him as he slinks from room to room. He is alone, uninterrupted in his search. Finally, in a dingy, dust-encrusted room, he finds a trapdoor, carelessly hidden beneath a fraying carpet. The lock is rusted, old and crude, and breaks with ease as he takes his sword hilt to it. He whistles through his teeth at the collection before him. Hammers of Adra? Obsidian blades, dragon scale armor. I would say Adra, but I've heard people say in the game Adra, I believe. He replaces his sword with an enormous symboled blade of black and takes as much else as he can carry. Trapping the trapdoor back down, he hears a wailing, piercing screech. Panicking, he tries to run, but his collection is too heavy. He curses, dropping all but the sword, and scales a bookcase to the barred window. He smashes the glass with his sword and begins to bash at the old iron bars. Shouting in the distance renews his desperation, and with a great clang the bars fall from the window. He squeezes through the opening, every inch of exposed skin cut with glass, and runs, the obsidian blade on his back glowing faintly in a dark night. I wonder what it was he heard. A screech from where? Mors Somnus. You see a man lying on a mat, restless in sleep. He tosses about, unable to claim total peace. Behind his lids, his eyes dart about, and small moans of distress escape his lips. He rolls around, moving from lying on his back to his side to his back again, sweat standing out on his forehead. The door to his chamber slowly opens, the weak light from the hall outside falling across the sleeping man's face. This man, much younger than he is now, steps leisurely into the room. His feet rise and fall as he crosses the floor with calculated precision, never once making a sound. He approaches the man on the mat, slowly raising two daggers as he does. He stands over the man, staring down at him, intense hatred burning behind his rocky features. He doesn't move, a statue poised to strike at the man's bedside. The man's eyes fly open, blinking in confusion, trying to drive that sleep from his mind. He sees the boy standing over him, daggers at the ready, and the blinking stops. Terror replaces the confusion, and he only has time to say one word, "You!" before the boy is on him. He drops, planting a knee on the man's neck, and plunges one of the daggers into his stomach. The boy leans over, tilting his head back to reveal a large black scar that cuts across his neck from the right side of his jawline to his left collarbone. The man gurgles and makes a muffled coughing sound, trying to speak through his crushed windpipe. The boy looks at him again, locking eyes and holding his gaze as the man slowly slips away. He then lifts both daggers and brings them down into the man's eyes. Owie. Alright, let's check out this area. We'll look at these, all these boardwalks and stuff. I guess we'll head up to the lighthouse, too. A sailor. It's a wonder we didn't riddle our bow full of holes trying to anchor near those cursed Adra levees. The sailor gives you a once-over, sizing you up. Hey, eyes up here, buddy.
A dozen Adiran ships were shattered against these levees during the War of Defiance. Best to heed the astrologers, I find, where tides are concerned.
Mm. Place gets my blood beating in all the right places.
We don't want to know that, Durrance. TMI, Durrance. See if there's anything to be seen, any goodies, any people. It's always bittersweet sailing from home, but seeing exotic locations is a decent enough trade-off. He's sizing us up too, okay. Captain won't be happy to hear about this. This place is lively. There's plenty to do and see here. We can't open that. Sir, open that. Morseno. This young, lanky sailor is wringing his cap anxiously, sweat beading on his furrowed brow. His eyes widen as you approach, and he takes a few steps forward.
Well met, friend.
If you've a moment, you're not from around here, right? You don't look like you're from the docks. He looks around nervously. I could use your help. You're a sailor? Yes, ma'am. I signed on about half a year back. The pay's decent, and the sight of the sun coming up over the sea, I wouldn't give that up for anything. I just wish I'd asked about the captain first. What makes you think I'm not from around here? Like avoiding his main question. We, don't see many like you around here is all. He shuffles awkwardly, even on the docks. What's the problem? Oh, thank you. They weren't lying, saying you're a kind-hearted sort. He runs a hand through his hair nervously. Oh, we're getting a good reputation for ourselves. It's the captain, or rather, not the captain himself, but his chest, his sea chest. He keeps all his valuables in there, tucked away safe. I was unloading it with the rest of his things, what with us staying in port a couple days, and... I may have gotten a little distracted. Morseno nods toward the buildings nearby. I wasn't gone long, just an hour at the salty mast. I think we spend more time than that there. When I got back, the chest was gone. He sets a pleading look on you. It really hasn't been that long. Whoever took it can't be too far. But the shift's changed, and I'm on watch. I can't sneak off to look for it, and the captain will kill me if he hears of it. I'll get strung up on the yardarm. Please, if you could get it back for me, I swear by the flame, I'll make it worth your while. You can have my pay. I won't be spending it if Captain Fortunero finds out anyway. Any idea where the thieves might have taken the chest? Well, the chest itself is pretty heavy. Nobody I've asked has seen it getting carried around either. I figure they must have snuck it off somewhere nearby, just out of sight. They can't have gone far. There's a pretty good lock on it, too, so I'm hoping they haven't got it open. Unless they take an axe to it, I suppose. Oh, gods. If they've got it open, I really am done for. We'll look for it. I suppose it's not that thing. That's got a good lock on it, too. We can go on this ship, can we? I want to go on this ship. Our ship's been dry for months. I could use a drink stiff enough to wake a dead man. Let's go to the lighthouse, and then we'll head our way back up here. Maybe they've got it hidden in here. It is nearby.
A touch of Margrin's fire should settle spirits here.
Yeah, what are we going to do with Margrin's fire? Damage.
And what does the flame reveal?
Hopefully we'll be okay. Oh, we need a key for that. Where can we rest here? I thought we could rest in the salty mast. But it's not that kind of rest. Can I just... No. Okay, I guess we're headed back up this way then. We need a key. Now hiring builders. No experience needed. Naya?
Well met, friend.
As you approach, she eagerly turns to you. You interested in doing some construction work? Her clothes are simple, but nicer than most you've seen in Andra's gift. Pays good money. You could try looking for workers in another district.
I have. In Copperlane, they're just as bad. Everyone's full of superstitious nonsense about the lighthouse and the flooding of Andra's gift.
Andra's gift was flooded?
Back at the end of the War of Defiance, it was one of the finishing blows to the Edirian military. Cost us a lot, though. The whole district was supposed to be evacuated, but not everyone left in time. The Edirians put anyone they found to the sword. The lucky ones who escaped the slaughter drowned hours later when Hadrit's forces broke the dams.
Locals say the lighthouse keeper was one of the people who stayed behind, and one of the last to die.
I don't know why that makes the lighthouse any more haunted than the rest of the gift, but there you have it.
Have you gone inside?
Who? Me? Not exactly. See, my health is rather delicate, and all that dust... All right, when I saw two Amawa deckhands running as fast as they could down the pier, I lost my nerve, too.
I could take a look.
Good. About time someone put an end to this foolishness.
She rummages in her pocket and pulls out a skeleton key. As she hands it to you, she hesitates.
Just be careful. Not that I believe the ghost stories, but it is an old building, so watch your step.
Cool, we're getting in after all. I have some questions.
What do you want to know?
Do you know what might be inside the lighthouse?
If only. Nair shrugs. It's been uninhabited since they flooded Andra's gift.
Tell me about the flooding of Andra's gift.
Hadrit ordered it near the end of the War of Defiance. It was one of the finishing blows to the Edirian military. Cost us a lot, though. The whole district was supposed to be evacuated, but not everyone left in time. The Edirians put anyone they found to the sword. The lucky ones who escaped the slaughter drowned hours later when Hadrit's forces broke the dams.
Oh, I've seen all this, yeah.
You're not from Defiance Bay, are you?
Heh, what gave it away? The accent, or the fact that I was the dupe who paid good coin for this place?
I'm from New Haomar, on the northern coast. It's smaller than Defiance Bay, so I came here looking for some fresh opportunities, and maybe the chance to do a little good in this neighborhood.
What are you building?
An inn, allegedly. She brushes a single loose strand of her bun behind her ear. The gift needs a spot with a little more... class than the salty mast. This district has been in the dumps since the War of Defiance. It seemed ready for some fresh development. So imagine my excitement when I find this place, 3 floors tall and right on the water, for sale at a reasonable price. The seller suggested that there were other interested buyers, so I closed the deal before I had taken time to really look into it. Stupid. She shakes her head. Being from New Haomar, I knew about the floods, but I didn't know about the superstitions surrounding the lighthouse, and the cellar was gone by the time I found out. At this point, it'll be a miracle from the Lady of Lament herself if I make my investment back. Farewell. Let's look in this lighthouse after all. The Wailing Banshee. Cool. Screaming like a banshee.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
In we go. So I'm wondering if we'll finish this up in a few minutes. In 15, 20 minutes. It can't be that big. It's just a lighthouse. Ooh, 278 copper skeets. Nice. That alone is worth it.
A simple test.
Yeah, you can open that. Leather armor. And a soft hat. Sure, why not? Oh! They suddenly appeared all over. Shades. And a specter. Oh my god. And a shade. Okay. You know, we probably should have rested before this. Amplified thrust off of Aether. Aeloth will just wait a sec. Actually, Aeloth can cast a magic missile here at the shade. I'm gonna be surrounded by these things in short order. He has to wait until battle. I'll try to take down this thing first. Maybe we could run inside the room?
Yeah.
Soul shock off of Aether. Another magic missile.
Yeah.
Love.
Well, that thing flew up. Ouch.
The unseen.
Hey, Loth. running right into the restored light endurance. Oh my god, they're teleporting all over the freaking place. Who's this? Is this? That's Itumak. That's Theodas. Hit that thing. Hit that thing. Aether. Does a knockdown not work? Maybe it was interrupted. Holy Radiance. Hey. Sagani. Armor of Faith. Where is he anyway? Eder, Canna, Durance. He's right in the middle of all this crap. Magic missile there. We got bad stuff happening. He's dazed. Oh boy. We're all dazed. Everyone except for Canna is dazed. Nice. Minor. I think it's too late for our wizard. Has she got knocked down? Or is that Aeloth? So where is he? Durance is right here.
What?
I noticed that door closed. Oh my god, there's so many. You still can't cast anything. Okay, we got rid of one. But it seems like there's even more now. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Holy crap, Aurelio. I don't want to heal yet. He's only got 2 left. This is not good. Is anything currently hitting her, Sagani, that she could walk away? Etumak got the killing blow. They're awesome. Okay, you know what? You hit this one. You hit this one. Aeloth is down, of course. You hit this one. And Eder and find one that's damaged. Oh, this one, obviously. That's Eder. I don't think knockdown works on these guys. And where's Canna? Canna. Yeah, all hit this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right?
Eh?
I think we're getting a tax opportunity or something, because he's running around like crazy. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Are we really down one? That's great. Alright. Restore moderate. Who's the most damaged? Eder and Sagani. Theodas, Sagani. Oh, it can hit us all this way, I think. No, Canimus is out. That's if he can get it off. He did. Who's this? Okay. Marked prey on this thing. To Mac at this thing. This is Theodas? Okay. Go AoE, okay. Do this? Mind wave? Now, I think it only it doesn't hurt us, it hurts the foes, right? Foe AoE, okay, good. She might get interrupted though. But, worth a try, I guess. Now, the bad thing is we aim here. We should aim there. Oh, the beagle. Summon the beagle. I forgot about that. I don't thought that would work. Nice. They got up. Bashed around. Okay, get some more focus back here. Eder's getting hurt again. He's healing himself, though, with this... with his, what do you call it? His sword. Oh, wait, we got rid of those. Beagle dog! Awesome. Oh, hey! Get that one. Beagle dog, get that one. Durance, I guess... Is this a good time? I don't know. We seem to be holding our own, pretty much. I don't want to waste that last spell. We got rid of that one. I'm actually surprised by how well we're doing. Okay, this shade. Oh, the wolf is down. Oh, the fox, I mean, is down. Damn it. Sagani. Marked whatever on this. Wounding shot. Theodas. How's the beagle doing? You know what it is? The Spectre isn't even going because he's blocked by all these shades. Bad pathing. Or good in this case. Where you going, Sagani? Come around this way.
No!
She's stuck. Oh, she's being chased by the shadow here. Alright, I guess, where's Edair? Oh crap, they're too far away from each other. I would like to heal at this point, but... I can't get both. Unless I make her move a little closer. Hope it doesn't provoke an attack. Like, opportunity type thing. Heal. What are you doing? Theodos, I guess you're hitting this thing. Oh, the Spectre's back in play. Uh-oh. Too many. This is going bad now. We are hitting this one, right? Yeah, they did. Not good, not good. We're about ready to get rid of the shade. They got Aider. Who's left? Durance, Canna, and Theodas. I'm kind of like blowing past all this because I know we're not going to make it. This is Theodas. Canna. I know they're gonna draw attacks, I just want to take one more out. Wow. Theodos is the last one left, and we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 baddies left. And her weapon is useless. Goodbye, cruel world. Is she hitting? Is she hitting anything?
Eh?
I guess because her weapon isn't good enough. We don't see that she actually hit anything. That's great. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode when we not go to the lighthouse yet. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.